came to Louisiana selling potions from a jar. He claimed they could cure anything from a fever to a scar. And all the town folk gathered round to see as he cast his spell of wonder over everyone but me. See, the miracle man, he was a dapper Dan, full of eloquence and grace. And I could tell his charm was working by that look on Mama's face. She was buying more than meets the eye, because she left me and my daddy without even a goodbye. And daddy cried for 40 days and 40 nights, and so did I. From the emptiness inside, though I wasn't old enough to understand, whatever happened to my mama and that miracle man. Well, the years went by and one day I went a-riding into town. I came upon a commotion, there were people gathered round. And out in front of Emma Parker's place stood the man who stole my mama and my daddy face to face. My daddy stepped up to him and he drew his 45, and with both hands on that trigger stuck it right between his eyes. And just when I thought he'd send him to the grave, suddenly without a word he just turned and walked away. And how I tried as we were riding home that night to figure why my dad would put away his pride when he knew he had the power in his hands to put around a justice in that miracle man. Later on that night he came and sat up on my bed. He said, son, there are some reasons why that demon isn't dead. The good book says you reap the seeds you sow, and if you turn the other cheek, you'll find the way the righteous go. For if I would have shot him, they'd have put me in a cage, and I wouldn't be around here now to watch you come of age. And an orphan life can turn a boy to stone. Son, I love you far too much to watch you face this world alone. And in my mind, at that moment in the light, I came to find that everything you said was right. For the first time I could truly understand why my daddy spared the life of that miracle man. Yes, and now I'm old enough to understand. Was my daddy on?